Hello, my name's Donna Spencer, and I'm a website and application designer with a bit of a specialty in designing information architecture and navigation. Today, we're going to dive into mobile navigation, looking at horizontal navigation. Horizontal navigation bars can be at the bottom of the screen or top. Bottom bars are often called trays or tab bars, and top bars are often called tab menus. Bottom bars will anchor right at the bottom and they remain persistent, so they stay on screen. Top bars usually appear beneath a logo or branding, and they might scroll out of view, though I've also seen some that stay persistent as well. On small screen, horizontal navigation works when you have a very small number of top-level categories and they have very small labels. Bottom navigation is restricted to about four or five categories, including home, which you have to not forget, which clearly I do all the time. Top navigation can include more categories as it can be scrolled right and left, but it still needs to be a really small number or you're missing too much off screen. If your site isn't like this, for example, if you have more top-level categories or long labels, look at navigation, vertical navigation bars instead. One of the biggest advantages of this kind of navigation is that it's visible. People can see it on screen and they don't have to go looking for it. A second level can be added to horizontal navigation, but again, it will have to be small enough to work with the screen size available. So a small number of categories and small short labels. For top navigation, you can add a drop-down menu to show the next level. Just make sure the items are large enough to tap. For bottom navigation, you can add something like a pull-up menu to show the next level. These both don't need to be just plain lists. You can experiment with layout, perhaps putting items side by side or on a grid. In all cases, make sure you include a link to the top-level page as part of that second level. Otherwise, you can't navigate to that top-level page. Another way of showing second level items is to use the page itself to show them. This is good for sites where the content can work really well with this kind of layout. It often doesn't scale well to large screen though, so think about whether this will work for all sizes. You'll sometimes see websites that use an icon with three dots as an indicator of more and has a pull-up menu from there. This is a pretty clumsy way of including the overflow items, and many people will miss them entirely. If you need to include more than you think you can fit, it's really better to use vertical navigation and not have people miss out on those links. If you're going to be using more items at the top level than can be viewed on the screen, make sure you communicate visually that there are more there. The easiest way to do this is to make sure they're spaced in a way that one of them cuts off. And some style guides will also have them fade out at the end. So that helps people understand that there are more items there. And also, don't put really essential content off screen, as some amount of your audience is going to miss it entirely, just relying on what they can see without scrolling. Sometimes I've seen websites try to fit more items in by just using icons and not using labels. Don't do this. It's hard to create icons that represent the categories well, and it's also really hard for people to figure out what the icons are meant to be without putting labels on them. So that's not a good solution if you need more than, you know, four to five categories. So for small screen, horizontal navigation is suitable only when you have a very small number of top-level categories and they have very short labels. And that's actually pretty rare. It's only really small websites that can fit everything into such a small number of categories. I'm always surprised when I see large websites using this approach, but usually they've compromised their information architecture to fit everything into that small number of categories.